Everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know by now, I'm Lee, and we're back today with another video. Period. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to travel on a budget. I know spring break is coming up, and as a broke college student, I understand the pain and struggles of not being able to travel back and forth. So I'm going to be giving you guys some tips today on how I travel on a budget. Being that I live in Miami and I go to school in New Jersey, you know, sometimes I be getting homesick. So I want to go home for the holidays or just for a random weekend sometimes. And I know that is not realistic to just hop on a plane and go. I'm going to be telling you guys my tips on how I travel and how I do it in a cheap way. My number one tip is to use third-party travel sites. So like Kayak, Expedia, Orbitz, Google Flights is really good. These are just like websites that are gonna compare all the flights that are out there and for the dates that you want them. And then you could see which ones are cheaper, which ones are not, which ones are in your price range, and which ones are just ridiculous. This is gonna save you a lot of time rather than just, let's say, going on JetBlue.com or going on Spirit or going on Frontier or American, whatever airline company that you use, it's just gonna be cheaper. And I know some people prefer certain airlines, but these websites do compare all the airlines, so you're gonna be able to see the airlines that you usually fly, sometimes that you don't fly. But if you're on a budget, honestly, it doesn't really matter. So yeah. Number two is a really good one that I use all the time, is to get one-way flights. I know this sounds kind of crazy, but being that we're traveling on a budget, you know, you gotta be kind of smart with how you play things out. So what one-way flights are gonna do for you is basically reduce the amount of money that you're spending. So let's say a round trip flight from JFK to Miami is $325, and a one-way is $100, and the one-way back is $75. You're reducing the amount of money you're spending on a flight, being that you're just getting one way. Even though it might be on the same days, it's gonna save you so much money and so much time. So I definitely suggest that. Even with international flights, it works the same. So you wanna be very mindful of that. If you see an outrageous price for a round trip, just go and see the one-way options for the same dates, or maybe sometimes the dates that you have, too many people are flying on those days. I think the best days to fly are on Mondays and Tuesdays and Wednesdays, just because a lot of people are not flying on those days. So keep that in mind as well, because Friday, Saturday, and Sundays are like the worst days to fly, because everyone wants to fly on these days. Everyone is off of work on these days. So just keep that in mind as well, especially if you want to travel for spring break. Another tip is packages. So let's say you're going to Jamaica and a package is going to be so much better for you. So a package includes the hotel, the flight, and a rental car. So even though it may seem like a lot of money, when you break it down, it's going to be way cheaper to get all of these things in one rather than getting them all in separate purchases, as well as all-inclusive resorts. So let's say if you're going to Jamaica and you want to go to an all-inclusive resort, that is going to include food, the stay, the activities at that resort, as well as alcohol. So if you are of age and you want to have a good time and you know that you're going to be consuming alcohol within your trip, definitely look into these all-inclusive resorts or hotels, because it's gonna save you a lot of money and you're gonna get the bang for your buck. And that's pretty much what we want to do. I know sometimes people think, oh, flying to a different country or just traveling in itself is expensive, but if you plan with time, you're gonna get a really good deal. Another tip is this: I know sometimes it's not super reliable, but it can work out in your favor. If you're going to a location or a destination that you have family in, I suggest that you try to stay with them. Even if you don't get to spend that much time with them because they have work or whatever, it works out in your favor, because one, you're gonna have a place to stay. Two, you're gonna save the money and you can use that money to do other things. And three, you can hang out with your family after they got out of work or pick up their kids or do any of that. So keep that in mind. Never outrule the whole family thing. I know sometimes people can't handle the family thing, but it's gonna save you a lot of money. And especially if you're going on a long trip, so like a week and a half, 2 weeks sometimes, do look into that, because a week or 2 weeks in a hotel or an Airbnb does add up. And that's the purpose of all of this, to save your bread. Like I said before, with the one-way flights, another good thing to look at is connecting flights. I know some people hate connecting flights. I'm one of those people, but until recently, I got on a connecting flight and I found out that even if it is annoying, it saves a lot of money and you're getting to the same place anyway, period. So if you're trying to go to LA from New York, stop in Dallas or stop in Wisconsin or whatever weird state it wants to stop in, do that, because it might take a long time. It might be a few hours layover, but you're gonna get to your destination anyway. And if that means $100 or $200 less, sis, and don't worry about it. Bring your headphones, bring whatever you need. I know we all got the Netflix, Hulu apps, like we can watch TV. And what's a few hours in an airport? Come on now. And last but not least, I know a lot of people don't even think about this when they leave for their travel plans, but when you are going to an airport and you have to leave at 5 a.m. and your flight is at 6 a.m. or whatever the case is, bring food. If that is the case, the night before, go to your local Walmart, your Publix, your Wegmans, your Trader Joe's, whatever it is. Make yourself a few sandwiches or like your favorite salad or whatever. It's gonna save you $30 to $40 to $50, depending on your group or who you're traveling with. It's gonna save you so much money. And you know, those little $10 purchases, $20 purchases, you don't think about them, but they do add up. That $10 or $20 can be an Uber, can be a movie ticket, can be an activity. So just save that money and buy yourself a little meal the night before or the morning of, so that you're not paying $15 for a bagel at the airport. Because I know I'd be mad as hell when I want to get a coffee from Dunkin' or a coffee from Starbucks and it's like damn near $10. Like, what? Like, coffee that I can make at home? Like, no. And last but not least, my biggest tip for you guys is to plan. I know it sounds like people on a broken record, but if you plan with time, not 2 weeks in advance, not a month in advance, try to at least shoot for 2 months, 2.5 months in advance. It's going to reduce the pressure and stress that you have to find a flight and a hotel, and if you need a car or any of that, it's gonna reduce all of that stress and all of that pressure. You want to be as relaxed and carefree on your vacation. Nobody wants to be stressed on whether they're gonna get from point A to point B, or whether they spend too much money on their flight and now they can't afford the hotel. You want to avoid all of that. So do it with time. If you want, pick your destination and then plan backwards. Or if you're just like, you know what, I know I want to go somewhere by my birthday and I'm going to save X amount until my birthday and then I'm going to plan, do it that way. I'm just giving you guys tips on how to plan and travel on a budget, you know, because we all can't afford 500 first class flights. Like, it just doesn't work like that. So don't forget the one-way flights, Kayak, Expedia, Orbitz, Google Flights, packages, all-inclusive resorts, staying with family, connecting flights, and bringing food for your travels. If you did like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to your girl. I'm on the road to 1,000 subscribers, and you know every subscriber counts. So, smash that subscribe button. I don't want you guys to miss out.